Hi guys, this is Srinivas once again for you. Today we are going to discuss about a difficult concept in operation research. So that is transportation problems. Actually, the transportation is easy, but this is MODI method or UV or loops a bit difficult for you. Today I'm going to teach these concepts. So what is the transportation? Before going to the problem, what is the transportation? So transportation, the word itself saying the transportation means some sort of a commodities we are transporting from various origins to the destinations. Clear? So we will have some sort of a problem. So every management is looking for maximize the profit with the minimum transportation cost. Okay, we have some sort of a problem here. Just have a look here. So we have three commodities A, B, C. And we have a market 1, market 2, market 3, and market 4. Now we are going to transport all these commodities to all the markets. So all of you, what is the 6 mean? 6 stands for. So the minimum transportation cost is 6 rupees to transfer the commodity A to the market 1. In the same way, the tempo will repeat. So all of you, so we are going to transport all these three commodities to all the destinations, so that is market, with the minimum transportation cost. For that reason, first we are going to apply Vogel's approximation method, or we can treat it as a penalty method. For LPP, the penalty means bigger method. For transportation, penalty means that is Vogel's approximation method. Now, before going to that, first we have to check the supply is equal to demand is balanced or not. What is supply? That is, the commodity A will have a maximum supply is 30, and for the market 1, the maximum demand is 35. In the same way, for the commodity B, the maximum supply is 55, for market 2, the maximum demand is 35. So first we have to check whether the total supply equal to demand or not. Clear? If it is not satisfied, then we will move on to some sort of a dummy row or a dummy column to make the given transportation problem balanced. In this case, the total supply is 215 and the total demand is also 215. Now we are going to apply the Vogel's approximation method or a penalty method. So that is all of you. Take the minimum element from the first row, that is the penalty. Take the minimum element from the first row and subtract from the fourth row. Take the first list. The first list is 1 and the next list is 3. Your difference is 2. Take the first list and the next list. The first list 2, the next list 3, difference 3. The first list is 4 and the next list is 7, difference is 3. This is all about the row penalties. We will move on to the column penalties. So that the first list is 6 and the next list is 10, the difference is 4. The first list is 1 and the next list is 5, difference 4. In the same way, 2 and the same way, that is 4. Clear? So this is all about the penalties. So that is the difference of the first list and the next list. Now, after the maximum penalty, the maximum penalty with the least cell we have to allocate. The maximum penalty here we have 4. That is, there is some sort of a tie here. That is, if you observe this, so the maximum penalty with the least cell we have to allocate. That is the maximum penalty with the least cell. So the maximum penalty 4, for example, this is 4. The least cell is 6. If you consider 4, the least cell is 1. If you consider this, so the least cell is 3. So obviously 6, 1, 3, the least cell is 1. Why we have tested the least cell? That is, for the transportation, we are going to minimize the transportation cost. So obviously we have to consider this cell, that is A, 2. That is the minimum. So we are going to allocate the cell A, 2, that equal to minimum of supply, demand. So for this cell, the supply is 70 and demand is 35. So the minimum of 70, 35 is 35. That is, 35 will be allocated here. This should be 0 and the balance is 35. So 0 means that is the market 2 is vanishes. Okay, so we are going to vanish this column. Now we have the remaining table. That is, we have 3 rows and 3 columns. We have 6, 9, 3, 11, 2, 8, 10, 4, 7. These are about A, B, C as usual. 1 and we vanish it 2, we have 3 and we have 4. Again, we are going to find the penalty 2. by taking the difference of the first list and the next list. So the first list is 3 and the next list is 6, so the difference is 3. The first list is 2 and the next list is 8, difference is 6. The first list is 4 and the next list is 7, difference is 3. These are the row penalties. We will move on to the column penalties, that is P2. We can treat it as usual. So the first list is 6 and the next list is 10, difference 4. The first list is 2, the second list is 4, and the first list is 3 and the second list is 7, the difference is 4. Now, we have to look at the maximum penalty with the list. So the maximum penalty in this is 6. We don't have any sort of a tie here, we have only the single 6. So that is, the maximum penalty is 6, either the least cell is 2. We have to allocate the cell B, comma 3, that is the row number 3, that is 2. So that is all of your argument. Before that, we have to take the supply demand, that is 35, 55 and 90. One more, 85, 50 and again 45. So all of you, now we are going to assign. So that is the same way, that is the minimum of 55 comma 50. So 50 will be allocated here. This should be 0 and the balance is 5 as usual. So like that, so what we did here, we have to repeat the same thing here. That is 0 in the sense all of you. We have to remove this second. So that is the second call. Then the remaining, that is again. So the remaining is we have, let's say we have 6, 3, 11, 8, 10, 7. We have a supply, that is 35, 5, 19, 85 and 45. Again we are going to find the penalty P3. The first list and the next list, difference 3. 3 again, 3 again. For the penalty, the column 4. Now we have to take the maximum penalty with the least. So the maximum penalty is 4. We have a tie once again. The maximum penalty in this, the least cell is 6. In this, the maximum penalty 4, in this, the least cell is 3. Now we are going to allocate this cell. That is the minimum of 35 comma 45. Obviously, 35 will be allocated here. This should be 0 and the balance is 10. So that is, this row is vanished row. So that is A, B, C, all of you, A will be vanished. So that is this one, that is 1 and this is for 4. So A is vanished. Then we have 11, 8, 10, 7. So as usual, that is we have 5 and 90. We have 85 and 10. Again as usual, take the penalty P3. The difference is all of the 3. We have 3 once again. We have 1 and we have 1. So the maximum penalty with the least. So the maximum penalty, then there is a tie. If you consider this, we have to allocate 8. If you consider this, we have to allocate 7. So we are going to minimize the transformation because we are going to assign this. So the minimum of 90 comma 10, 10 will be allocated here. This should be 0 and the balance is 8 and this call will be vanished. And hence we have only one, that is 11, 10. That is 580 and we have 85. So unanimously, it's very difficult to find the penalty. So obviously we have to allocate the least cell. So that is, these are the least cell. Take a part, that is this one 80. Okay, no problem. So this one, so 80 will be allocated here. This should be 0 and the balance is 5. And only one thing that is other than, that is 5 and 5. This will be 0, that's 0 and 0. It means we are going to transport all the commodities from the origins I to the destinations J. These are what the penalty method is completed. Now we will move on to the MODI method. So these are the question. Now I am going to assign all the allocations here. For 1 we allocated 35. For 3 also we allocated 35. For 2 we allocated 50. For 7 we allocated 10. For 11 we allocated 5 and for 10 we allocated 80. Okay, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 allocations. First we have to check the occupants in M plus N minus 1 condition. What is M? M is the number of rows and N is the number of columns. We have 3 rows and 4 columns minus 1. That is 7 minus 1, that is 6 allocations. This transformation table consists of 6 allocations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now the minimum transportation cost, so that is minimize Z equal to double summation Cij Xij, that equal to
35 into 1 plus 35 into 3 plus 50 into 2 plus 5 into 11 plus 80 into 10 plus 10 into 7. That is obviously 1161. That is minimized cell. So what it means, all of it, the minimum transportation cost to transport all these commodities like A, B, C to the market 1, 2, 3 and 4 is 1165 rupees. Okay, now we are going to apply MODI method or UV method. Now consider occupations. Now consider the occupations. So there is 1, 2, 3. We have 1 now. The occupations, so there is 1. Here we have 3. 11, 2. And again 10. And this is 7. Now this is all about drawings and meetings. So now we apply a UV method, all of you, or MODI method. The condition for occupations is UI plus VJ equal to CNG. Now assign 0 to maximum allotted row. Here we have 2 allotted rows. So that is, in the first row we have 2 allocations are take place. In the second row also 2 allocations, the third row also 2 allocations. So we can put 0 in any of these 3 rows. I am taking 0 here. So the condition of the UI, this is all about UIs, this is all about BJ, this is all about CAGs, that cells, CAG means. So 0, so we have to put some sort of value, it means 0 plus something equal to 3. So 0, if you are going to add 3, obviously we will get 3 here. Again, we have a 0 here, we have to get 1. So how much we have to add here? 0 plus 1, obviously 1. We have a 7 here, we have a 3 here. 3 plus 4, 3 plus 4 is 7. That is UI plus VJ equal to CAG. This is the condition of. And we have a 4 here, we have a 10 here. We have to put here, all of you, 6. So that is 4 plus 6 equal to 10. We have a 6 here, we have a 11 here. 6 plus something equal to 11. 6 plus something means 6 plus 5. 6 plus 5 equal to 11. We have a 5 here, we have a 2 here. 5 subtract, so 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. Should I repeat once again for you? Sure, I will repeat once again. Take 0 to maximum allotted rows. We have a, for each and every row we have 2 allocations, no problem. I am putting 0 here. 0 plus something equal to this cell. 0 plus something in the sense, I am adding 3. 0 plus 3 equal to 3. We are adjusting the condition. UI plus VJ equal to CAG. UI is 0, VJ is 3, obviously CAG is 3. So that is 7 is there, 3 is there. We have to add some sort of 4 value. That is UI plus CJ equal to VAG. So 3 plus 4 is 7. 7, 10 here. 4 plus something equal to 10. 4 plus 6 equal to 10. 6 here, 11 here. 6 plus 5 is 11. 5 is here, 2 is here. These are about 3. So 5 minus 3 is 2. We have a 0 here, we have a 1. 0 plus something equal to 1. So obviously 1. These are about occupied cells. Clear? Now we will move on to unoccupied cells. Now consider unoccupied cells. And make it a point, we have to use all those values. We have occupied and we have unoccupied. So in this, the unoccupied cells are 6, 9, 5, 8, 12, 4. Now as you UI plus VJ equal to CAG. Minus 3 plus 0, minus 3. 3 plus 5, 8. 1 plus 5, 6. 6 plus 0, 6. 1 plus 4, 5. Minus 3 plus 4, 1. Okay, now we have the next condition, that is ZJ minus CJ, obviously the natural condition greater than or equal to 0. So ZJ minus CJ greater than or equal to 0, here we go, the condition. That is 1 again, 2 again. Judge A minus C is 6 minus 6, 0. 9 minus C 2 minus plus 3, that is 12. 5 minus 6, minus 1. 8 minus 8, 0. 12 minus 5, 7. 4 minus 1, that is 3. All of the net emission conditions all rather than 0. Here, the net emission condition not satisfied. We have a minus 1 here. Like LP, simplex method and Big M method, we have some sort of minus of maximum, plus of minimum, like MBR. In this case, the same tempo. Here, that is minus 1. This is all about the entering sum. So that is, UV method is over, but there is some sort of a negative, that is, we will move on to loops concept. Clear? So we have the remains data, you make sure that the value 1165. Now we are going to apply some sort of a loop concept. So it means what? Again, we are expecting some sort of a minimum transportation cost. So apart from 1165, some sort of a money we can reduce for transporting all the commodities to all the markets. So now here we have an entering cell. So here in the sense, all of you, in this position, we are going to have some sort of a loop. So the loop will start here. The loop will run from all the occupied cells. For example, if we start here, for example, you move upwards. So move upward means here we have occupied cell, luckily. So here. And then from here to here, and luckily we have occupied cell here. And again from here to some sort of a jump. This one, like again, some sort of a jump. Again, we will have a loop here. I mean, to see the occupied cells. Once again, from double jump, we have an occupied cell here. And again, we have an occupied cell here. And finally, we will reach here. So, this is all about the plus theta, minus theta, plus theta, minus theta, plus theta, minus theta, and again plus theta. We have a one loop here. Or else, we will consider in another way. This one, from here to this one, this is star, this is occupied cell, again this is occupied cell, again this is occupied cell, this is occupied cell, this is also occupied cell, and again we are reaching the same point. This is S star. That is all of you. Plus theta, minus theta, plus theta, minus theta, plus theta, minus theta, and again plus theta. So the loop will follow in occupied cells also. Without loss of generality, I am taking this loop. No problem whatsoever. Now, R of theta, here we have 35. And here we have 35 once again. Here we have 10. Here we have 80. Here we have 5. Now, we have to consider minus of thetas. Why we have to consider minus of thetas? Again, R of theta, minus means minimizing. So still we are expecting 1165 is a very huge amount for transportation. So that's why we are applying this loops concept again. That is theta equal to, that is our minimum of theta, so that is minimum of the theta is how much of you, that is 35 minus theta, 10 minus theta, and again we have 5 minus theta equal to 0. So the minimum is obviously 5 minus theta equal to 0, theta equal to 5. Now all of you, so these are, so simply I am adding theta, I mean we have a plus theta, so plus theta means I am going to add, minus theta means I am going to subtract. So in this case, as usual, I have a 1, 2, 3, 4, so that is the loop is like this all of you, plus theta here, plus theta, so the loop is upwards. Like this, and like this. Plus theta, here we have minus theta, plus theta, minus theta, plus theta, minus theta, again plus theta. Clear? So as usual, 6 is as usual, and we have 1 here, I'm writing 1. 35 minus theta, the value of theta is 5, 35 minus 5, that is 30. 9, and we have 3. 35 plus 5 is 40, and we have 11, 5 minus 5 is 0, that is 5, and 5, and here we have a theta, no? So theta value is how much? 5, and that is 52, 54 as usual, 8 as usual. 18 plus 5, that is 85. This was 10 and this is 12. 4, that is 7. 10 minus 5 is again 5. Now we have a condition 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have a condition, the same data we have with 10 plus n minus 1. That is 6 conditions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, the minimum of z here, the minimum of z equal to alpha as usual. 13 to 1 plus 14 to 3, like what we did. Sure, you people are going the value 1160. Clear? So, in the previous data, we got 1165. Here, we got 1160. That is, for each and every product, we are going to reduce 55 rupees. Okay, so again, after this, the as usual, we have to check the condition for occupied cells and unoccupied cells. Now, consider occupied cells here. Now, consider the occupied cells. So, forget about the previous table, just focus on this table. Focus on this table. That is the occupied cells are, that is 1 here, that is 1, 3, 5, 2, 10, 7. Now, as you can assign maximum the number of allotted to 0. So, in the previous table, we assign 0 here, that is ui plus bj. Now, I am going to assign 0 here, no problem. That is 0 plus something equal to 2. So, 0 plus something means the value should be 2 only. So, 0 plus something, we have a condition of ui plus bj equal to cij. So, this is ui and this is bj. 0 plus something equal to 5, so that is 5. 5 here, 1 here. 5 minus 4 is 1. Minus 4 something equal to 3. That is alpha 7. Minus 4 plus 7 is 3. 7 is 7. So, 7 plus something, 0 equal to 7. 0 something, 10 equal to 10. Now, this is for occupied cells. Now, unoccupied cells. Now, consider unoccupied. Again, we have 3 rows. Unoccupied cells here, 6, 9, 11, 8, 12, 4. As usual, minus 4, 0, 0, 10, 5, 2, 7. Ui plus bj equal to cij. Minus 2, minus 4 is minus 2. 7 plus 0, 7. 2 plus 0, 2. 5 plus 0, 5. 10 plus 0, again 10. And 10 minus 4, that is 6. Okay guys, so the final we have a net emission condition, Zj minus Cj, rather than equal to 0. So simply the table like this. We have 3 rows, 4 columns. Zj minus Cj, 6 minus 6, that is 0. 9 minus 2, 11. Next again, 11 minus 10, that is 1. 8 minus 7, that is 1. 12 minus 5, that is 7. And 4 minus 2, again 2, all of them. If you check here, all the values are positive. Hence, the net deviation condition satisfies. But what in case here, we have all the net deviation. For example, if you got some sort of a minus 7 here, for example, the net deviation condition is not satisfied. Again, we have to start the loop here. Again, you have to consider this table. Again, we have to start here simply occupied cell, occupied cell, occupied cell, and again straight to the starting point. So, luckily, we got here positive. So, hence, the minimum transportation cost is 1160. Thanks a lot for watching this video.